The question from Senator Johnson and the other senators for both parties. Recent reporting described two NSC staff holdovers from the Obama administration attending an all-hands meeting of NSC staff held about 2 weeks into the Trump administration and talking loudly enough to be overheard, saying, "We need to do everything we can to take out the president." On July 26, 2019, the House Intelligence Committee hired one of those individuals, Sean Misko. The report further describes relationships between Misko, Lieutenant Colonel Vindman, and an individual alleged as the whistleblower. Why did your committee hire Sean Misko the day after the phone call between President Trump and Zelensky, and what role has he played throughout your committee's investigation? The House will begin.
First of all, there have been a lot of attacks on my staff. And as I said when this issue came up earlier, I'm appalled at some of the smearing of the professional people that work for the Intelligence Committee. Now, this question refers to allegations in a newspaper article which are circulating smears on my staff and asked me to respond to those smears. And I will not dignify those smears on my staff by giving them any credence whatsoever, nor will I share any information that I believe could or could not lead to the identification of the whistleblower. I want to be very clear about something. Members of this body used to care about the protection of whistleblower identities. They didn't used to gratuitously attack members of committee staff, but now they do. Now they do. Now they'll take an unsubstantiated press article and use it to smear my staff. I think that's disgraceful. I think it's disgraceful. You know, whistleblowers are a unique and vital resource for the intelligence community. And why? Because unlike other whistleblowers who can go public with their information, whistleblowers in the intelligence community cannot, because it deals with classified information. They must come to a committee. They must talk to the staff of that committee or to the inspector general. That is what they're supposed to do. Our system relies upon it. And when you jeopardize a whistleblower by trying to out them this way, then you are threatening not just this whistleblower, but the entire system. Now, the president would like that, nothing better than that. And I'm sure the president is applauding this question because he wants his pound of flesh. And he wants to punish anyone that has the courage to stand up to him. Well, I can't tell you who the whistleblower is because I don't know, but I can tell you who the whistleblower should be. It should be every one of us. Every one of us should be willing to blow the whistle on presidential misconduct. If it weren't for this whistleblower, we wouldn't know about this conduct. Misconduct. And that might be just as well for this president, but it would not be good for this country. And I worry that future people that see wrongdoing are going to watch how this person has been treated, the threats against this person's life, and they're going to say, why stick my neck out? Is my name going to be dragged through the mud? Will people join our staff if they know that their names are going to be dragged through the mud?
Thank you, Mr. Manager.
Senate. There's two responses that I'd like to get to. One, with regard to the issue of witnesses, in this case, the whistleblower. Mr. Schiff put the whistleblower issue front and center with his own words during the course of their investigation. He talked about the whistleblower testifying. Retribution is what is prohibited under the statute against a whistleblower. That's what a whistleblower statute protects, that there's no retribution. In other words, they're not going to be fired for blowing the whistle. But this idea that there's complete anonymity, and I'm not saying that we should disclose the individual's name, and you handle that in executive session or any way you'd want, but we can't just say it's not a relevant inquiry to know who on the staff that conducted the primary investigation here was in communication with that whistleblower especially after Mr. Schiff denied that he or his staff initially had even had any conversations with the whistleblower. It goes back to the whole witness issue, and I want to go to that for just 30 seconds here. It seems to me that the discussion for witnesses, I heard what Mr. Schiff said about the 30, we'll do depositions in a week. Democratic leader said I could have any witnesses I want yesterday. I've got it in the transcript. And you couldn't get all the witnesses you'd want in a week. You couldn't get the discovery done in a week. But if in fact they believe that they've presented this overwhelming case that they have, they talk about subterfuge and smoke screens. The smoke screen here is that they used 13 of their 17 witnesses to try to prove their case, and we were able to use those very witnesses to undercut that case. So I think we just have to keep that in perspective. Thank you, Mr. Chief Justice.